Sorry, timer. Come on, timer. All right, here we go. Hi, my name is Beth Hiley, here for Board Game Geek at Essen 2013. I'm sitting down with Corne van Mossel.
Hello.
How are you doing? And you brought us Mayday! Mayday! Which you have to say big because you put exclamation points in the title, so
The artist did that and then I took it over. So I changed the name on Board Game Geek also.
Well, you know, it works out pretty well in the end, I think. So, Airplane. Danger,
yeah.
Flight attendants.
Mm-hmm. In this game, the setup is in an airplane. All players, 5 to 8 players, they are all part of the crew, the airplane crew. And the pilot suddenly died, and it's a mysterious situation. People don't trust each other anymore because people think the crew thinks that he is murdered. And the co-pilot is not trusted too, and now we must find first a new pilot. And then form a new, smaller crew and make that the infiltrators are out of the crew. Because we know at the start of the game that there are infiltrators in the crew. And yeah, the honest people must make sure that only they are finally in the final crew. It's 5 to 8 players. I did set it up here for 5 players.
All right, so each player's got kind of a little setup here.
Each player has his player color. You have your own, you have your card with a defense side, protection side, and the attacking side. And that you use that during the game. If you trust someone, you say protect, and if you don't trust the person, then you can say attack. And you make that choice simultaneous, and your card you hold under such a card that you get at the start.
Mm-hmm.
And then you don't see your choice. And once everyone did choose, then you reveal your choice. But first, the complete setup. You have your own color. And you have 4 flight pin markers in the game. And you have they have both sides, 2 sides, sorry.
Right, so we have a heart here and then the
heart
and
a broken heart, precise. Mm-hmm. And the heart means you place that at the player, another player card. If you say that that you see a normal heart there, and if you say that you see an infiltrator heart, that means the broken heart, then you place it at on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
So first we must get those cards. Everyone has at least 2 cards. They all have the secret the question mark sign on the back side, but there are two different, one with the normal heart and one with the broken heart. This is the normal honest crew member and this is the infiltrator crew member. Everyone has one of each, and there will be 5 more in the game in case of 5 players.
Mm-hmm.
3 honest players in case of when you are playing with 5 players. And 2 infiltrator cards. You shuffle these cards until you don't know anymore what is where. Of course. And you give every player 1 of those cards. And then you look at it secret.
Okay.
Then you know what you are, honest or infiltrator. Then you mix them with the other 2 cards you have, still secret. So you know what you are now, then you mix them until you don't know where it is anymore, because it's 1 card of 1 and 2 of the other. You can also say you give it to your neighbor to make it safe, if you don't trust each other. But I don't know anymore where it is. And then you place them side to side, like this, in front of your cards.
Hmm? And we would do that for everyone else.
No, everyone does the same. So then it will look like this. Like this.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So,
yeah.
Oops. Mm-hmm. All right, so now we're ready.
Mm-hmm. So everyone knows now what he is, but does not know where the different
cards
are.
Where that card is, yeah.
And the smallest group, that is the infiltrators group, they will know from each other who are the infiltrators and who are not the infiltrators. That goes like the werewolf game, so everyone now closes his eyes, mm-hmm. and then only the infiltrators open their eyes. You probably.
I don't know, I'm not telling.
And then they look at each other and then they close their eyes again and then everyone opens his eyes. And then the infiltrators know each other and the others still don't know who is what. That's the start setup. Then the object is to make, the other people must find out, of course, who are the infiltrators. There will be a kind of elimination round for going. We must choose a new commander, a new captain. Mm-hmm. And the new captain goes in three rounds. First, three players will get the benefit of the doubt. That's this card. Once those three are divided, then two will promote to reliable. So suppose this player has benefit of the doubt and this player gets benefit of the doubt and maybe you. Then two of those players will become reliable. And that's this side for. One card goes out of the game because it goes from 3 to 2. So this is the reliable card. You see people on it should look a bit more reliable. And that's always two, also with 6, 7, and 8 players. And then one of those two will be chosen for becoming the new captain.
Okay.
And that choosing that goes every time with the simultaneous choosing with these cards if mm-hmm. you trust a player or not.
Trust, yeah.
And then the maturity determines. Once there's a captain, then the captain must choose another player who is also gets cockpit entrance. He gives that player, suppose you become the captain, then you get the first cockpit entrance card. Then you must give another player cockpit entrance, maybe this player, and that player must give another player cockpit entrance, maybe this player. I'm not explaining it very smart, maybe I must get a bit used. I did not sleep, but the order I explained is not so super, but I will explain everything. So that's how it progresses, but then you don't know yet how you get benefit of the doubt and what how we learn about these cards,
yes.
Of course. Okay, let's go down to that part then now. At the start of the game, so we made the start setup. We have these cards in the middle. And there's one of these cards. All players get one of these cards. There are more in the game, but with five players, you only need four of these plus, five. Yeah. With five players, you need these five. I selected it right. You shuffle these. In a prototype, this part worked a bit different, but this is better. Then you give all players one of these. These games arrived yesterday, so.
Hey, I'm glad they arrived.
It's all looking right, I think. Then all players look at their own cards. There can be text on it. The text is only if you have the special card that tells that you must reveal it direct. Then you show that card direct.
Like I have one that says reveal immediately. Yeah.
All other players don't show it, and the text for the other players are only for if you play the game already more than once at least. Then you are allowed to use the text on it. So sometimes if you are playing with new players, they are not allowed to use the text, and the experienced flight attendees can use the text on it. You got this card, that means simply that you get the first skirmish card. It's this card. That you get the skirmish card. And this card you still hold, you show it to make clear for everyone that you get this card. You still hold it because you use this card for making the choice secret. But the first skirmish now will be about you, so you will not choose. But first, before we choose if we trust you or not, we must first look, we learn first a bit about our neighbors. The idea is that at the start everyone knows a bit about his neighbors. You will have a look at my most close to you card. So have a look at this card.
Okay.
Make sure that only you see it during
Got
the
game. It.
And then you say what it is. You can, if you are an infiltrator, then you are allowed to lie about it. If you are an honest person, then you should speak the truth about it.
Okay, well, I'm going to say then that that was an infiltrator card.
This is an infiltrator card.
Don't trust you.
Then I don't trust you anymore. But, and you can say that, of course. And you show that by placing the this marker.
So people remember that that's what I...
Then it's clear during the whole game that you did tell. So you don't have to remember anything. You do the same at your other neighbor, so you look at this card also.
Okay, so look at that one. I think they're fine, so I will put a little chippy out like that.
Okay. Then that neighbor does the same to you and to his neighbor and so on until the last player. So this player, maybe he says this is honest, maybe he says this is not honest and so on, just to give it something. Sorry, black.
Oh, here.
Here. Green, maybe green tells that these are all infiltrators. And suppose this is the situation. Now I must also look at my neighbor. And I can choose quick because I'm honest. Of course, when you are infiltrated, then you must not think long because then it's very suspicious.
Yeah, that's true.
And you are the infiltrator. I'm honest, I know that. If this if this happens, that my neighbors both say this is an infiltrator card, then I already know that one of my neighbors must be an infiltrator, from my point of view.
From your point of view, yeah.
Others also know that one of my neighbors must be an infiltrator if I'm honest. And so you can make deductions already at the start and during the game more and more because we will see more cards. And I'm smiling because it's a funny game. It will be a lot of fun these days. And I'm really honest, but of course everyone tells that. But I know that one of my neighbors must be honest. Infiltrator if this happens, or maybe both neighbors.
Now, of course, people who truly are infiltrators, two out of these three are going to be the evil card, yes?
Yes, yeah, that's right, yeah. And if you are honest, then two of these cards are honest cards, so then I know that this, if I really am honest, then I know that this cannot happen because this can be an honest card, but then there must be still here or here also an honest card. I want to say something more. Oh yeah, but yeah, of course others, I say that of course, but for others I look very suspicious at the moment. So, and this player is also looking very suspicious, but it can be that you are an infiltrator and that your infiltrator cards are at both sides and that the honest people are next to you and telling this. But in practice, you don't have to worry about the situation. In practice, when you have two infiltrator tiles, like here and like here, the chance that player is really an infiltrator is about 50-50.
Okay. All right. So what happens once we've made all this?
Yes.
These decisions?
That's just the start. Then you are the first skirmish player. And that means that there will be a skirmish about you to determine if we trust you enough to give you the benefit of the doubt.
Okay, so I'm guessing this person, based
precisely.
On that, and I'm going to put that right in the middle there.
Yeah.
So the black player over here is going to make
he will have a look at one of your cards.
Okay.
He can check, maybe he does not trust me and thinks this was a lie. He can check this card or he can check this card. He can also say maybe these are both right and let's see the middle card because that can be decisive.
And then the green player is going to do that?
Yes, but no, first. Okay, suppose this player, maybe this player looks at this card, sees what's on this card, and maybe that player tells that it is an infiltrator card. Now there are already three infiltrators in this game, which is not possible. So people are... It's already certain now that there are people lying, because if no one is lying, then this cannot happen. because three infiltrates is not possible with five players. So this is what happens when the opposite player looks at one of your cards. And then all the players choose if they trust you or not by placing this card. Maybe this player maybe tells, I don't trust you. But you can hold that secret until all players chose.
Right, and then we all reveal at the same time. Well, then, everyone but me.
Then everyone but you. If you are trusted by two or more, half or more of the people is enough to get the trust.
Okay.
Three must punch out of four in case of five players. Three of the four other players must punch to make that you don't get the benefit of the doubt. And suppose most players punched. Suppose I don't trust you too, maybe. And then all reveal and maybe the most players did punch. Then you don't get the benefit of the doubt, so then you don't get one of these three cards. And to show that you are not available for the benefit of the doubt anymore, you place these.
Place sideways. All right. So what happens when the skirmish is done?
In the example picture, it's precise like this, but it's not important. Then the skirmish is done, then this shifts simply to the next player.
And we do the same thing.
So this player now will look at one of the cards and maybe this is not so interesting because there's a big chance that this is at least an infiltrator card. So maybe this player wants to check one of the neighbor cards, but it can also be that the middle is still interesting.
Yeah, and we go around the whole way around the table.
Then there will be again a fight. Skirmish is the idea for this player. If maybe that player gets trusted enough, then that player gets the benefit of the doubt. Then the skirmish card shifts to the next player. And so on until these are divided. Suppose this player gets the benefit of the doubt card, and this player too, then I don't get the benefit of the doubt card, of course, because there are not any available anymore. Suppose this player does not get the benefit of the doubt card, then there's only one left, and then it must go to me automatically. So there will always be three players with benefit of the doubt card. In that situation, the skirmish card was at this place. Then the skirmish card again goes clockwise to the next player, but now to the next player with one of the three benefit of the doubt cards.
And so we just do here.
And then it's precise the same, but now not the left opposite player, but now the right opposite player.
Got it, because we're on the second level now for two stripes, then I imagine we would follow the arrows for the captain.
For the captain. Suppose I get the benefit of the doubt, then I turn it like this. If I don't get if I don't promote to reliable, then I lose this card and it goes out of the game.
How long would you say a typical game takes?
It's about 20 minutes.
Okay, so this goes by very quickly once we get rolling.
Once the captain is chosen, suppose that I'm chosen to be captain finally.
We have about 2 minutes left, so we gotta wrap this up pretty quickly.
Yeah.
Casino, we have to land the plane.
When I'm the captain, then the skirmish card does not play a role anymore. Then I turn the skirmish card. Now it shows that I've cockpit access as new captain. Then I shuffle my cards. And then I reveal them. And then you see it's still going right for the honest players. And now we did not know who did lie here because I shuffled my cards. Mm-hmm. That's the reason for that. Uh-huh. Then I choose one player who looks at one of the other player's cards. It must be a player who still has tiles available. By the way, you can never see more than one card of another player, so you must always combine the knowledge from different players. And then I must choose one player who also gets benefit of the doubt card from the middle. Maybe I say this player. Then that player shuffles his cards, reveals the cards. Just for the example, let's see.
And now it goes wrong. Infiltrator.
And then the honest people lost and the infiltrators won direct.
Dun, dun, dun.
If that was also an honest player, then he must choose the last honest player for the last cockpit entrance card. But now the infiltrators won in this game.
All little pieces of information lead to a whole chain of deciding to trust.
With every skirmish, there's a little bit more information. Mm-hmm. One card is seen by a player, but then you must try to estimate if he is lying or if not. And more and more it gets clear, and sometimes it's complete found out, and sometimes not. It's always on the edge.
Well, Corné, thank you so much for stopping by and showing us Mayday! Mayday!
I look forward to have it in the booth next day.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm just going to slide this in the box, yep, so we can clean this up really fast, because we are typically